Also, let's talk about the Tiffany Teals, as I like to call them, of course, because, you know, the seven richest electorates in the country went off and spoilt themselves after 2 years in lockdown and got a Tiffany Teal independent. Now, of course, they're all totally independent, but already you're starting to talk about a voting bloc. And, Gary, they're already talking about we need new rules for question time so we get more questions. We need a code of conduct for Parliament, which presumably just means they get more time to talk than anyone else. But I thought they were all independent.
Look, Paul, they are, of course, a spare caucus for the Labor Party, because the people that elected the Teals were invariably Labor supporters who did the numbers and realised the fastest way to change the complexion of what had traditionally been safe Liberal seats was to, in fact, join forces with the Labor Party. Their agenda is all of the Labor Party. A lot of former Liberal voters decided that they didn't like Scott Morrison, and they wanted to beat up the local, you know, fairly, in a lot of cases, fairly woke members. And they thought, well, we'll vote for the Teals because everyone's talking about them, and we'll just get on there. We'll scare these jokers back into some sort of common sense, real Liberal Party approaches to things. They overdid it, Paul. So the combination of the Labor voters and a few Liberals who thought this was a way to send a message to Scott Morrison delivered these people. They have no agenda other than the Labor's agenda. So they're following the Labor Party agenda. So, of course, they want reform of the Parliament because it's code for less questions from the opposition.